Hi guys and welcome back. So today we are going to be focusing on a yoga, Pilates inspired type of flow. Something that's going to really help to kind of warm up all those joints and prepare you for maybe when you're going into a workout or perhaps just for the start of your day. So we're going to start at the bottom of the mat. And from here, we're going to tuck the toes in behind us. So we're going to take the little baby toes, really wrap them underneath you. This is just going to help you to really release any tension held in the base of the feet and in the toes themselves. From here, back is up lovely and tall. Deep breath in, sweep the arms up high to the sky. Inhale. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Exhale, take the right arm down by the side of your body and reach up and over. So we're going to just open up the side body here, inhaling and exhaling. Reach up, switch sides, and reach up nice and tall. Take the arms behind you, roll the shoulders back, interlace the hands, sending the shoulder blades down the back. Inhale, and exhale, chin to chest. Exhale. Inhale, rise up, nice and tall. Take the arms out in front of you, rolling the arms forward, sending the back back, opening up the upper back. And then inhale, rise up high. Exhale, take the hands out in front of you here. So from here, we're going to sink back into the hips, roll the body forward. Exhale, release back into the hips. So starting to find a little bit more movement into the joints, starting to lubricate the joints up a little bit here. Deep breaths in as we draw forward, exhaling and releasing. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. This time we're going to draw ourselves forward into a plank position. So we're nice and strong, tuck the tailbone under. So you're tilting the pelvis up and in. Broaden the shoulders, deep breath in. Exhale, inhale, exhale. We're going to do some scapular protraction. So from here, you're sinking the shoulders towards each other and then you're expanding the shoulders. So retraction and retraction, okay. And protraction, sorry. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Making sure we don't bend the elbows. Inhale. And if you find it more comfortable, you can be on your knees as you drive it up. So drawing the shoulder blades towards each other, opening up the shoulder blades here. One more time. Open. And then release. Bring the knees back in underneath you here. So releasing the feet, we're now going to walk the hands back. So we're going to open up the roof of the foot. So you can take the hands behind you, lift the chest up, opening up the shoulder blades and the collarbones. And then exhale, release, bring it back in towards you. From here, draw the right knee up towards the chest and switch. Left knee into the chest and switch. Right knee. Good. Left knee. One more time, both sides. So really engaging the abs as we draw the knees up and in towards us and release. So from here, we're going to then start to take the knees out to the side, taking some little hip circles for four. Now, as we do so, I want you to draw the knee up towards the elbow and release it back. So we're not kind of just randomly circling. We're drawing the knee up to the elbow and out. One more time. And then from here, let's lift that leg out to the side and down. So coming to our fire hydrants, exhaling. And we're going to take 10 of these. For 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, squeeze at bottom, 9, 10, draw that foot behind you, coming into an attitude. So we're going to lift the knee up. So a little bit of bar inspiration here as well. 4, 5, draw those tummy muscles in. 6, so we're engaging the glutes now. 7, 8, that knee should be parallel to the floor. 9, 10, and then extend the leg out, draw the heel to the bum, and you're pressing the foot out. So we're going to engage the hamstrings here for 2, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Draw the knee through, step it forward, reach the arms up high, inhale, big crescent lunge, coming into what we call Anjanasana with the knee down. Good. Exhale, take the hands down, release the foot. Okay, so we're now going to open up the hamstrings. We just warmed up the hamstrings, so now we're going to open up, reach the chest forward, inhale. Exhale, release. Inhale, draw it forward. Exhale, release. Inhale, draw it forward. One last time. Exhale, release. Now this time you can bring it all the way down. So you're sitting onto your heel here. And then you're going to walk the fingertips forward. Now obviously only come as far forward as feels comfortable. Inhaling. And exhale. You really do want to work with the breath. That's going to allow you to release into the leg. Don't overextend. So if you find the back of your knee feels like it's pushing down into the floor, but you're feeling you're overextending into the knee, or you're naturally hypermobile, just watch that and maybe just soften the knee a little bit more than normal. Inhale, rise. Step that left leg back. And now we're going to switch sides. So I'm going to spin around just so you can see me from this side. So from here, take those little circles again. So knee to elbow and back out. Two. Three, four, two more, five, six, good. And then draw the knee down and open out fire hydrant. Now again, just watch as we lift this leg, you're lifting the leg and you're squeezing the bum. You're not rocking into the left hip, so you're not dropping into the left elbow. You're keeping the body up nice and tall. So everything feels engaged and you can feel that engagement into the glute. Two more here. Last one. And then let's bring that knee round. So the knee is parallel to the floor and we're squeezing the bottom here. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, one. Extend that leg out behind you. Draw the heel to bum and squeeze for one. Now really be mindful that that knee stays up here. It's not dropping as you come down, okay? You keep the knee up high so that glute stays engaged and you're working the hamstring at the same time. Four more here. Three, two, one, draw that knee all the way through, step it forward, look ahead. Inhale, rise, big stretch. Exhale, take the hands down, release back, toes to the sky. Inhale, move the body forwards, coming into this front lunge, opening up the hip flexors, and then coming all the way back, opening up the hamstring. Now, if you want to hold the hamstring stretch a little bit longer, that's absolutely fine. For the purpose of what we're doing today, we're just trying to get some body heat into the try and get some blood flow through the body here. And, you know, really want to make this quite a short little session so you're prepared for A, the rest of your day, B, it's not going to take up too much time, and C, if you have got a workout ahead of you, you are ready and raring to go. Good. From here, sit it all the way back. Again, sitting onto the bottom, onto the heel. Back is tall, chest is lifted. Exhale, walk the hands forward. So deep breath in, exhale. Now, another little tip just to get a little bit deeper. Imagine you're scooping the belly up and over the thigh rather than just kind of collapsing down in the stretch, okay? So if you really think about scooping over, you'll probably find you come a little bit deeper, okay? Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, rise, come back up to our foot. And now we're going to step both feet back together again for me. And then taking the hands in front of you, we're going to work into those fingers. So take the knees about hip width apart now, and you're going to come up into the fingertips. So this is great for A, sort of like grip strength, and B, really getting the ancillary part of our bodies working really well. So that's hence the feet and the hands. So we're really working through each side. So you're switching from one side and then going into the other. Now, you want to make it harder? Come into plank. Come up into the fingertips, release and switch sides. Now, if this is too much, as I say, just do this in your kneeling position. And one more time. And now we're going to work into wrists themselves. So from here, you're going to gently move into your wrist, little circles here. And again, if this feels too much weight-bearing wise, come onto your knees. It's all good. Deep breaths in and out. Good. Two more. One more. And then moving forwards. Release. Move forward. So we're engaging that core. Two more. Last one. Bring the knees back down. Take them back underneath your hips. Take the fingertips towards your knee. Now, I would start off initially with one hand and then switch and go to the other hand. For those of you who are a little bit more bendy, you may feel comfortable taking both fingertips to the knees. You also may wish to, again, only if this feels comfortable, slowly release back, finding that inner forearm stretch. So again, really working into wrists, hands, forearms, all of these little bits we kind of ignore. And then finally, take the back of the hand to the floor, back of the hand to the floor. Again, you could do this as a single and do one at a time, entirely up to you, or you could do both at the same time. Good. So from here, we're now going to just work into these arms. Now, tucking the toes in, press the bottom up to the sky, release the head. Take a deep breath in here. So we're coming into a down dog here, inhaling, exhaling, making sure hands are in line with the shoulders. Good. One more breath, inhale, exhale. If you want to pedal out the backs of these legs, by all means do. And if you want to get a little bit deeper into the legs and into releasing the glutes, just draw the knees side to side. Good. Last one. And then from here, let's work into some of this upper body strength. So taking the hands out to the side, you're going to bend the elbows, draw the head towards the floor, and then drive it up. Now, you can make it as easy or as hard as you wish to. A, either not coming quite so low, or B, maybe taking the feet a bit further back, or you make it a bit harder, bring it back in a little bit closer. Bringing in and drive it up. Four more. Three. Two. Last one. Good. And release. Now, coming into your heels, again, you could take the feet back further if you prefer. Take the hands in front of you, and you're going to sink down into the forearms. Draw into the fingertips, ground down, press it up. For four. Inhale, exhale. Three. Two. One. Good. And then bring the hands back into a neutral position along to the shoulders. And then we're going to take the feet back again. Soften into the knees this time. So a little bit like what we did at the very beginning, but this is called Turbo Dog. And we're going to ripple the body up and over into our plank. Hold. Exhale. Soften into the knees. Roll the body up and over. Hold. One more time. Roll the body up and over. And this time, exhaling, coming down nice and low. Hold into our chaturanga press, or narrow press up. And release. Roll the shoulders back. Engage. Come into a mini cobra here. So we're engaging the lower back. And now coming into our full extension here. So we're going to take the arms out in front. Lift the legs off the floor, opening up, hyperextension of the back. So engage in those back muscles for five, four, three. Squeeze that bottom, two, one. Take the arms behind you. Roll the shoulders down the back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two more breaths. Lift those legs up a little bit higher if you can. Good. Take the arms back out in front of you. And little swimmers here. Slightly different to our normal swimmers. So we're keeping the body lifted. For five. Four. Three. Two. One. And then take the elbows out to the side. Knees out to the side. Feet together. Lift the knees off the floor. Lift the chest off the floor. For four. Three. Two. One. Gently release. Take the hands down by your side. Roll the shoulders back one last time. Inhale for a cobra. Roll the shoulder blades down the back. Exhale. Bend into the knees one last time. Bending into the toes. We're going to jump forward. Take the knees to the outside of the arms. So we open up the hips. Open up the knees. Maybe reach up tall. Opening up the torso. Inhaling. Exhaling one more time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And now from here, take those arms out in front of you. Lower down to the floor. Draw the feet out in front of you. Hold. Coming into this half boat position. Lift the chest up tall. Inhaling. Exhaling. Inhale. Exhale, extend the legs. Inhaling. Exhaling, well done. Inhale. Exhale. Two more rounds of breath. Should be shaking now. For four, keep the chest lifted. Three. Two. Slow lower, keep it controlled. Nice and controlled, hold. Keep it drawn in. Four, three, two, and release. Good work. Release the arms down by your side. Take the feet in. And we're just going to finish off with a little glute bridge here. So taking the hands towards the feet, slowly roll up through the back. So you're sinking the pelvis down, and you're going to roll through the middle and into the upper back. Squeeze the hips up, hold it here for four, three, breathe, two, one. Interlace the hands underneath you, roll the shoulders underneath, opening up the chest, draw the tummy muscles down and in, pressing the palms away. You may be able to bring your hands together or maybe just fingertips together. Inhaling, exhaling. One more breath. Doing so well. And then slowly relax the hands out to the side. Take your time rolling down through the upper body, middle back, all the way down into the lower back, coming into our neutral spine. Draw the knees into the chest. Give yourself a hug. And then we're going to rock and roll. Take the hands behind the thighs. And we're going to do that three times for one, two, all the way up, three, bring the feet together, and we're gonna take a little rock, get your bottom as close to your heels as feels comfortable while still being able to get the knees out to the side. If you find your knees are like here, bring your feet further forward. Okay, so nice deep breath in, back is tall, chest is lifted, hands around the ankles, but try not to grab on for dear life. Inhaling, roll the shoulders down the back. And exhale, sink the elbows down into the inner thighs here and draw the chest forward. So rather than collapsing forward, I want you to really just draw the chest forward. Inhaling. And exhaling. One more breath. If you feel comfortable here and you want to take your hands to the floor, please do, or maybe hands to the feet, just drawing the body forward into forward fold. One more breath. Inhale, slowly rise. crossing the legs. You are done. I hope you enjoyed that session. Do let me know if you enjoyed it. Please do comment below. And of course, if you can subscribe and like this, then it allows me to make you more videos. And do let me know what else you'd like to see. Take care.